guys, it's Carol here. Welcome back to my channel. Today it's going to be the next segment of our series, our self-help series here that I started on this channel a week or two ago because of you guys. So thank you so much for your feedback. You're definitely directing the route and path of this self-help series. So if you're new to our channel, I'll link below the previous videos I've done. The video that inspired this basically, and then the intro to the series. And then today what I wanted to talk to us about, or I wanted for us to think about and talk about, is self-talk. Because most of you, if you've been following me on this self-help series, you remember I mentioned that I struggled with depression in the past. I haven't gone through that type of depression, that long-term depression, in like I said, 10 years now. And so that's what kind of spawned this self-help series, with questions like, how do you do it? How did you stay out of it? How did you get out of it? How do you not go back there? And things like that. So I thought, you know what? I need to start with self-talk. What are we telling ourselves? I really want those of you who are really struggling with depression and whatever you're struggling with, I really want you to take inventory and write down, what are you telling yourselves right now, okay? Because the truth of the matter is that negative thoughts can come to all of us, okay? But what matters is what we're doing with those thoughts, okay? So I believe in God, I believe in Jesus, I believe in angels, so I believe in positive spirits, and then I also believe in negative spirits, okay? And I have, you know, personal stories I can share with you about that, that makes everything very real for me, okay? Times that I've been attacked, you know, with negative spirits. In fact, just last night, I was attacked as well. And so, you know, in the moment, it's creepy as hell, but I have felt such a strength in combating even negative spirits against me. Because for me, what gives me the most confidence is that I have a higher power. I have a God and angels and powers that far exceed their powers. They don't want anything to do, you know, with positivity and angels and God and the Word of God. They don't want anything to do with that. So I'm armored with that. So even though they can try to attack me and, you know, but I have something that they cannot win against. So in terms of biblically speaking and that kind of talk, that's one way I'm able to armor myself, is prayer and reaching out to God and the angels and asking them to protect me, because I need it. So whether you believe in God or you don't, or spirits or you don't. Okay, let's just talk about thoughts, okay? They're gonna come to us, okay? They come to everybody, but it's a matter of not accepting the negative thoughts, or like, let's just say like, I don't know, let's say it's a negative occurrence that happened. Like for example, you lost your job, or you got a bad grade, or you're going through a breakup in a friendship or a romantic relationship of some sort, you know, something that like negative occurred that it's like you really didn't want it to happen, you know, something like that. So while there may be things that we can look at it and think like, gosh, I could do better here, we don't need to accept those negative thoughts that come to us, such as it's all your fault, such as you failed, such as you're a failure, such as you're never gonna find anybody else, such as, oh, just, you know, there's nobody good out there for me, or I'm just not smart, or I'm just not capable, there's something wrong with me, or I'm not good at this, and, you know, I'll never be good at it, or I can't do it, or, you know, there's something wrong with me. What else? I mean, I don't know. I'm sure you all are familiar with every single thought, you know, I'm not pretty, I'm not good enough, my body isn't nice enough, I do this too much, I eat too much, I cuss too much, I don't know. I'm sure you're aware, you're completely aware of these negative thoughts, okay? And like I said, we all get them. And while, let's just say some things may be true, like let's say, for example, you suspect your teacher doesn't like you. The truth of the matter is, maybe she doesn't like you. Maybe he doesn't like you. I've been a teacher and I can say that yes, there are some teachers that don't particularly care for some students, okay? And there's good teachers and then there's some teachers that are not in the field, you know, they're not in the field for the right reasons, okay? Or let's say you think your boss doesn't like you. She or he may like you, or she or he may not like you. And there's really nothing you can do about the fact that they don't like you, whether it's for a good reason or a bad reason. Whether your teacher likes you or dislikes you for a good reason or a bad reason. Whether you caused them to not trust you or not like you, or whether you caused them, I don't know, whatever. Or even if you didn't, you may have not caused them anything. They may just not like anyone, or they may be intimidated by you, or they may not know exactly what to do with you, or they may, you know, there just could be a lot of reasons. Okay, so let's take the example that let's say your teacher or your boss or someone, some authority figure, doesn't like you. And let's take the example that it's for the wrong reason. They were told something about you that's not true. But I don't know, let's just say you don't have the facts, okay? You don't know for sure. You just sense a strong energy that this person does not like you. And let's say you really didn't do anything. You're thinking, I cannot think of a reason why they don't like me, you know? So don't what I'm saying is, that's an opportunity. Every day there are opportunities for these negative thoughts to come to our mind. And so we have to think about what we're going to accept and what we're not going to accept. Okay, so for example, they may not like you. Let's just say the truth is they don't like you, and you don't know why. Maybe it's not a good reason. You could interpret that and take it as, oh, they must not like me because I don't, like, maybe I'm just not a good employee. Maybe I'm just not good at my job. Maybe I'm not good enough for them. Maybe I'm too slow. Maybe, my work, you know what I mean? Like, you know what route I'm going, basically. You're basically faulting yourself. You're faulting yourself and you're thinking of, there's something I'm doing wrong that is probably not the truth, okay? You know, and so we cannot do anything about that situation besides what we're telling ourselves. So as long as you're doing everything that you know in your heart to be the right thing to do, then you really cannot control that person. Okay, now I also believe that we don't have to allow someone to treat us badly, and we don't need to put ourselves in that situation. So if you feel like you're, you know, in a classroom or you're at work and it's just a horrible environment, then find ways to get out of that environment, because we spend most of our time at work. And so start looking for jobs elsewhere. But don't internalize it as, there's something wrong with me, no one else is gonna wanna hire me because they don't like me, there's no jobs out there, you know what I mean? Like, don't start saying things like that, okay? If you're going through a relationship breakup of some sort, you know, don't internalize that as, there's something wrong with you. Oh, you're not pretty enough, your body isn't good enough, you're not as pretty as this person, you're not as good looking as this guy, you're not as successful as this person, your job isn't as good, you don't get paid as much. You know what I mean? Like, don't start downgrading and down talking yourself, because sometimes it really has nothing to do with you. And actually, a lot of times it has nothing to do with you. It has nothing to do with us. It's something that it's something they're dealing with internally, okay? A lot of the times it's something they're dealing with internally, okay? So, but if you find yourself in an environment that you really feel like, gosh, this is a horrible environment, people are just, you know, it just makes me feel horrible when I'm here. Again, take inventory and think about, is it really them or is it you? Is it all in your head or no? Is it really this situation? They're doing things that are not ethical. They're lying. If it's things like that and you feel like, gosh, I really don't want to be associated with this, or this is putting me in a tough spot, or it's just draining me, I'm coming home every day miserable. You know what I mean? Because yeah, I mean, it's hard to combat negative things like that when it's like all day long. I mean, if you can avoid it, avoid it. But if you really can't, you're just like with these people all the time, then start looking for, you know, another job elsewhere. because you have to believe and have faith that there are other positions out there for you as well that your strengths and talents can be utilized for. And just because one person doesn't like you doesn't mean that other people won't like you, you know? Just do the best that you can do every day. Go in, do the best that you can do, and stay true to yourself and try not to get involved with the negative, you know, things going on, and just try to do your job the best way that you can and keep your integrity. And, you know, when you go home, look for an opportunity to move to another place, you know, if you feel like there's really no options there, okay? But self-talk is super important because it's very easy for people to take all those things and make it their truth and their world. You know, they start living out that lie that they're not pretty enough, that lie that they're not smart, that lie that they're not capable, that lie that there's no jobs out there. And they start closing off all the opportunities and all the options that the world has to offer. While there is a lot of negative things out there in the world, there's also a lot of positive things out there. There's a lot of good people out there. There's a lot of good companies out there. There's a lot of good leadership out there. There's a lot of good work out there. Sometimes there's work that may not exist in the moment, but it's about to be created for you. You just have to keep a positive lens on what's out there. Yes, be aware of the negative things because you don't want to go back into that type of environment or relationship or whichever friendship. But keep in mind that there are good people out there and there are good opportunities and options out there for us, okay? So, you know, that's something that we really need to be mindful of and stop telling ourselves negative things. You know, I want you to think about someone to you that you feel like matters so much to you, whether it's your child, a best friend of yours, your spouse, your mother, your father, your sister, your brother, someone you're mentoring, someone that mentors you. Just think about someone that means so much to you. Someone you feel like some type of like, you want to protect them in some way, okay? So now that you have that person in mind, how would it make you feel to watch that person be told such negative things, such as, you're so ugly, you're never gonna make it, who the hell's gonna want you? You're not good enough, you're not smart enough, I mean, look at you, you need this, you need that. If someone was telling that person that right in front of you, would you just stand there and allow that? Or would you somehow stick up for them? Because that, if this person is super important to you, then that should just have a fire erupt out of you to stick up for that person and not allow that person coming at them with all this negative energy and negative talk, not allow that person to do that to that person that you love. So we need to do that, and we need to treat ourselves like that. We cannot allow these negative forces and these negative thoughts and words to be accepted by us and to make that our truth. I think my son's awake. Hi, Angel. So, you know, like, that's how I feel with people I love. You know, I would never want them and their spirit to crumble because of someone doing something to them, and I damn well would stick up for them. That is such in my personality against whoever is doing it. I don't care who that person thinks they are, or how powerful they may, or how much power they may have, in whichever manner. Yes. I'm not going to allow someone to ever think that they can control me, and that they can rule me, and that they can rule my thoughts, and that they can rule my friend's thoughts, or whoever it is, my son, whoever. So that's the way we need to treat ourselves. We need to love ourselves enough and value ourselves enough to be like, oh, hell no, that's not true about me. I am smart, I am capable. Maybe I have some room to grow in this area. Maybe I need to strengthen this skill, but I'm gonna get it down. You know, maybe I'm not, you know, maybe my body doesn't look like this person's, but I can get it in a healthy state, or you know what, I love my body just the way it is. You know, I'm healthy and that's all that matters. Or, you know, maybe this isn't my strong suit, but that's okay. I have a lot of other strong suits that I'm really good at. So, you know, take advantage of all the pros that you have within you, because we all have pros and we all have areas that are not our expertise, and they're not things that come naturally to us, things that we have to work at, you know, and that's okay. No one was built perfect at everything, okay? Everyone has areas that they can grow and strengthen, and that's what living our life is all about. Is it's about, you know, utilizing our talents, our gifts, our skills, and making our world better through those gifts that we are given, but also strengthening all those areas that could, you know, get some improvement. So the challenge that I want to offer you today is, like I said, take note of what you're telling yourself. If you have to write that down and keep a journal of it, I really want to challenge you to, when that thought comes to you, to say no and have some type of a positive response towards it. You know, I'm not ugly, I'm beautiful. I'm not perfect, but nobody's perfect, you know. No, not every day I'm the best cook, or, you know, maybe not every day I'm the best at work or the best parent, or I mean, always, you know what I mean? Like, we all have this image of what we would love to be, but every given day we're gonna fall short somewhere, okay? Because we're not perfect. And so have grace for yourselves in the areas that you can strengthen and the areas that you can fix. And if you've made mistakes, then you made a mistake. And so look at the mistake you made, try to fix it, try to make it better. If you have to apologize to people, then apologize to people if it's hurt anyone. You know, if it hasn't hurt anyone, let's say it's a mistake you made on the job, then just apologize and say, you know what? Yeah, I messed up, but own up to it. Own up to it, you know, and say, this is going to be an opportunity for me now to make this better in the future. Like, this is an area I need to work on, obviously, but I can get it better. Because believe me, you can. There are so many times, and I can share that in another video, but there are so many things that it was not my strong suit at first, but because I was determined to make it, you know, something or make that an area that I could be really good at, I did. I made those areas. You know, I'm just thinking, for example, like in teaching and things like that, where there's things when I first started out that, you know, I could use improvement on. If you want to know what I'm talking about, like in the very beginning, it was having in my lesson the reason why this particular topic and these skills were needed in the world for my students. And so at first, when I had my mentor, you know, that was something that I saw that I needed to improve on. So it actually turned into my strength. It actually turned into the number one thing that I looked at, besides, you know, wanting to inspire my students, but it became something that was really important to me to build that connection on why this was going to be valuable to them. Because let's be honest, sometimes when you're in class, you're thinking, God, I don't see anybody, they don't even know this, you know what I mean? But, you know, you want to teach them that it may not be needed, you know, necessarily on an everyday basis, but it's going to be valuable in certain situations in your life. It's going to be valuable to know this information. So that was one area. Just that's the point of today's video, is be mindful of what we're telling ourselves, and help if there's someone in your life that's depressed and they need help. You know, number one, you know, they need to see a counselor and have someone to talk to if they're able to afford it, or get insurance for their work. But also, you know, just take note of what they're telling themselves and point out all the good things, okay? So I'm going to stop there, because this is a very long video, but I hope it was beneficial and helpful to you guys. Feel free to, you know, again, like, leave down your request for the next video, what topic you want me to cover next. I have topics that, if no one says anything, I'm going to go on to next, because, you know, people left those requests, but I thought this is the first thing I wanted to start with. So I hope you guys feel some type of little boost or something today. My heart goes out to you guys who are struggling with this, but I know that you can get through it. I know you can get through it. I know you can have a happy life. I know you can turn all of this around and live a life that you feel productive and successful with. So I hope you have a good day, you guys, and I'll see you in the next video. So in the meantime, work on that. And if you want to email me, my email is down below in the description box, but I'll just let you know it's also mommygoodness@gmail.com. So Take care, you all, and I'll see you all in the next video. Subscribe if you're new, and make sure you give this a thumbs up to support the self-help series. All right, bye guys.